Today we're gonna explore how we got from this to this. Let's cut open a f***ing tire. Polymer! Ha! This is cars down to the atom. Rubber has been around forever. We know that Mayans were using the sap from the rubber trees over 4,000 years ago. Raw rubber, or latex, occurs naturally. Harvesting natural rubber is difficult for a lot of reasons. Enter synthetics. So in 1931, American company DuPont successfully industrialized synthetic rubber. They did this by taking petroleum-derived monomers, like this ethylene, and bonding it to other molecules to form long chains like this, polyethylene. The monomer becomes a polymer. That's what that means. You're probably wondering, hey, are my tires real rubber or synthetic rubber? Your car's tires are probably mostly synthetic, but if you drive a bus, plane, or a tractor, there's probably more natural rubber in your tires. So how did we get from a white blob to a solid black tire? Vulcanization! Vulcanization makes rubber tough, and we have Charles Goodyear to thank for that. He accidentally dropped latex and sulfur together on his stovetop. And guess what? Tougher rubber! Goodyear died broke, though. He invented a process perfect for making tires 100 years before cars. Goodyear Tires? That's not his company. That's just an homage. Just like Nikola Tesla did not found Tesla. With heat as a catalyst, the sulfur molecules act like bridges between polymers, binding them. What's a catalyst? Well, it's like when you're at your ex-wife's wedding. Everybody's just milling about. Well, there's a punch bowl there. Drop a little homemade LSD in that.
You got yourself a party. Party, party, party.
They found that adding some metals to the vulcanizing process helped things along, and one that was particularly good was zinc. It made the rubber tough, but it also made the rubber white, like this. That's why the Michelin man looks like he's made out of marshmallows.
Only our standards are high.
Carbon black, a waste product of the petroleum industry, was added to make the tires last longer. But it changed the color of the tire to black. The process was a little bit more expensive, so they only used it on the part of the tire that hit the road, the tread. Black tread and white walls. White walls! So how much harder is carbon black rubber than regular white rubber? We're gonna find out. Round two. So bad. Okay, this lit right up. This smells horrible. I'm gonna throw up. And now for the carbon black tire. Holy sh**. Guys, it's not melting! It's smoking, but it's not melting.
Thanks, carbon.
Okay, look at this. So this is the non-carbon black rubber that they just used to use on tires. You can see how it's a goopy mess. Wait, it's coming off on my fingers. It got so hot that it actually melted the rubber. That's what we were talking about. You can see it here on the road. It's this sticky little mass. This tire with the carbon, it's nice and solid still. Yeah, it heated up. Yeah, it spit off these pieces. This is still whole tire. It didn't melt. That's the beauty. Nowadays, tires contain all kinds of stuff. What kind of stuff? Let's find out. Boy, that was fun and easy. What we've got here is a radial tire, and we got the first one of these bad boys in 1949. So what is in this? Here, we got this nice hard carbonized rubber we've been talking about. And then up in here, we got nylon, we got vinyl. In here, you're gonna see we got a lot of steel threads, and then a thicker caliber thread down here. That's what's gonna seal to your wheel. This is some heavy duty shit. And If this was a self-sealing tire, you'd have a bunch of goop in here that would seal up a hole if you ran over a nail or, I don't know, a porcupine, because those are sharp. Rubber has gone from being a flimsy, fragile novelty to a modern automotive necessity. I mean, picture a car without rubber. No belts, no hoses, no tires. You're going nowhere. And all that fancy fiber and plastics, we wouldn't have any of that without polymer research inspired by rubber. Well, I hope you enjoyed getting into the nitty-gritty properties behind what I think is the most overlooked and overworked part of your car with us today. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. I can't wait to do more of the science with you guys. Hi, Mom.